Today at iFixit HQ, we have two of the most poorly reviewed devices that I've seen in a while, the Humane AI Pin and the Rabbit R1. Reviews aside, these are two very interesting devices, not only from a design perspective, but also as a peek into a future with AI by our sides. The Rabbit R1 is an LAM or large action model designed to be an AI assistant that complements your smartphone. The Humane AI Pin, on the other hand, is an LLM or large language model, and it's an AI device designed to replace your smartphone. One is a chunky screen with tons of character, while the other is sleek and small and clearly designed to be reminiscent of a Star Trek communicator. Which one is more deserving of your hard-earned cash? Well, that's for you to decide. What we want to know is what the hardware looks like and whether it's repairable. So let's dive in. First up, the Rabbit R1. It's been a while since we've seen an entirely new category of device, so I'm wondering where the entry point is on this thing. No screws in sight, so screen or backplate? I opted for heat and some elbow grease on the backplate. Theory confirmed, this is a rear entry device. If you're trying this yourself, consider using some isopropyl alcohol around the edges to loosen the glue. I'm not sure what I was expecting to see, but it wasn't this. The interior is charming, with the oversized motor and gears standing out almost like the R1 were a steampunk gadget. The battery is glued to the backplate and comes in at a slim 3.85 watt-hours. Having used the R1 briefly, I can tell you it needs a bigger battery to be useful as an AI companion. Let's pop all these press connectors at the top. The camera and motor assembly seem pretty accessible, so let's undo the screws holding it in place and remove them as well. That speaker is next. It's held down by one screw and one of these connectors. Let's pop them both off just to be on the safe side. And away it comes. We found the source of our mystery connector. Underneath the speaker, I've got a Haptic motor which is glued against the front half of the case. The button on the input wheel turns out to be a single metal shaft that slides out. With that, the rotary encoder, aka input wheel, can pop out with a little gentle persuasion. Last but not least, we've got the mainboard, which houses the processing power to run the device, but not the large action model itself, which lives in the cloud. Which begs the question, could this whole thing have just been an app on your phone? Humane's take on the Star Trek communicator is the next device on our teardown table. It's not every day we get a new device category, so I'm left wondering how to get into this thing. I opted for heat on the backplate and a bit of elbow grease. Inside, we find what at first glance looks just like an Apple Watch. Very pretty aesthetics. Let's make the rounds and remove every one of these T2 screws on the outer edge. I want to disconnect the battery next to avoid any unintentional damage, but there's not a single pull tab in sight. In such cases, I like to inebriate my battery and excise it with a pick. Removing a single bracket reveals the press connector I'm looking for. The tiny internal battery pack has a capacity of just under 1.1 watt-hours. Let's go ahead and remove the press connector for the wireless charging coil next. We did a whole video about inductive charging recently. Go check it out if you want to find out why this device overheats. I'm going after the last screw holding the top bracket in place, after which I can remove the speaker and microphone assembly. Underneath that, we've got press connectors for the laser projector, the camera, and what looks like an ambient light and proximity sensor assembly. Once those parts are out, all that's left is the mainboard, which, like the Rabbit R1, contains the processing power to run the hardware it's attached to, but not the LLM residing in the cloud. For that, you need a data or Wi-Fi connection. Moving to the external battery pack, there's only one way to get into this thing, and the top does pry away fairly easily. Removing the cover reveals the connector to the wireless coil and two rows of magnets. Four screws and a good deal of alcohol can wash away the pain of removing this battery and the bottom plate that makes contact with the charger. The external battery measures in at a tiny 1.79 watt-hours. When it comes to repairability, both of these devices have batteries that are a pain to remove, hidden behind thoroughly glued down panels. A lithium-based battery is generally good for about 400 charge cycles, and you're gonna go through an awful lot of charge cycles very quickly with these devices, which makes the difficulty of getting to the batteries in each respective device that much more perplexing. While Humane left us plenty of fun messages to find during the teardown, they neglected the more important task of making the interior battery accessible for easy replacement. Both of these devices are the AI equivalent of "this meeting should have been an email." Both, at best, should have been an app. But that might have more to do with the restrictions on Apple and Android's app stores than anything else.